So now we have the differential equations that govern current and voltage along a transmission line. But what does it mean? What are the actual solutions for voltage and current? Well, to find these solutions, we will first assume that both quantities are proportional to a time harmonic, meaning that the voltage and current may be written like this. This lets us rewrite the wave equations like this. Here, the time dependence cancels out, and we see that the second spatial derivative of each quantity, whether voltage or current, is equal to the quantity times a constant, which is this whole term. To make our solution as simple as possible, we'll give this term a name. We'll call it gamma squared, where gamma is the complex propagation constant. We will also specially define the real part of gamma as alpha, the attenuation constant, and we'll define the imaginary part as beta, the lossless propagation constant. So gamma may also be expressed like this, gamma equals alpha plus j beta. Notice again that if the line is lossless, R and G both go to zero, and gamma becomes purely imaginary. In that case, alpha equals zero, and gamma equals just J beta, where beta is omega times the square root of LC. Looking back at our wave equations, we can simplify the expression using our new definition of gamma, like this. And this is a simple second-order differential equation with solutions that can be expressed either as sines and cosines or as complex exponentials. We will choose to use complex exponentials here. In these solutions, V0 plus, V0 minus, I0 plus, and I0 minus are all variables corresponding to magnitude. Each of these solutions consists of two parts, which signify two possible directions of propagation on the line. It's possible for a signal to propagate in the forward direction, or the plus z direction. For the voltage, this signal is signified by this term, V0 plus times e to the negative gamma z. It's also possible to have a signal propagating in the backward or negative z direction. For the voltage, this signal is signified by this term, V0 minus times e to the plus gamma z. This is important to remember. The terms with exponents of negative gamma z are propagating in the positive z direction, and the terms with exponents of positive gamma z are propagating in the negative z direction. The total voltage on the line is the sum of the forward propagating and the backward propagating components. Now remember, our total solution for the voltage and current waves involved a time-dependent term. So our whole solutions for voltage and current look like this. These equations are most commonly expressed in phasor form, which assumes the harmonic rather than explicitly stating it. So if a quantity is given in phasor form, it may look like this. But you have to remember that the e to the j omega term is still present, even if it's unstated. The solutions may also be expressed in the time domain like this. Notice that here, the real part of gamma had to be pulled out of the cosines. So the solutions to the wave equations for voltage and current along a transmission line include both forward propagating and backward propagating components, and all components consist of harmonics that decay exponentially with propagation, according to e to the negative alpha z.